This presentation is going to look at confidence intervals for variance and standard deviation. So first we need to find the point estimate, and for the variance of the population, that is going to be the sample variance. And for the standard deviation of the population, it will be the sample standard deviation. So from that, we can use a chi-square distribution to construct a confidence interval for both the variance and the standard deviation. So if a variable has a normal distribution, then the distribution of chi-square will equal n minus 1, so the sample minus 1, times s-square, the sample variance, divided by the population variance. And we'll form a chi-square distribution for samples of any size greater than 1. The chi-square distribution has four properties. The first is that all chi-square values are greater than or equal to 0. So it's not like the t or z scores where we have negatives. The chi-square distribution is a family of curves, much like the t distribution, all determined by degrees of freedom. So to make a confidence interval for variance, we use the chi-square distribution with degrees of freedom. And to form a confidence interval for variance, we use the chi-square distribution and the degrees of freedom equal to 1 less than sample size, much like the t distribution. The third property, the area under each curve, is 1, also like both t and z, although we're not talking about a normal curve. And 4, the final critical value of z corresponds to the given level of confidence. 5, the chi-square distributions are positively skewed. So as we build a confidence interval for variance or standard deviation using the chi-square distribution, as with the z and t distributions, we need to find a left and a right cutoff value. There are two critical values, therefore, for each level of confidence. And we have chi-square r for the right, chi-square l for the left. And this is shown here in these graphs. And the area in between is the critical value c. So here's an example finding critical values for chi-square. For an 80% confidence interval when the sample is 18, we have degrees of freedom equal to 17 because it's n minus 1. So first we find the area to the right, which is chi-square r, and that's going to be 1 minus c divided by 2, or 1 minus 0.8 divided by 2, which gives us 0.1. And then we look at the area to the right of chi-square l, which is our left tail, our left side cutoff. And that is going to be 1 plus c divided by 2, or it's going to be the complement of the other. So that's 0.9. And then we use the chi-square distribution table to find the critical values. So with 17 degrees of freedom, we find the values for 0.9 and for 0.1. And here they are, 10.085, 24.769. And so these are the c confidence intervals for variance and standard deviation. For variance, here it is. We're looking to capture the sample variance, or the population variance rather, using a left and right endpoint. And those are found through these equations, n minus 1 times s squared over chi square r, which we showed we could find on the critical value table. And then chi-square left over here, which we could also find on the table. And for standard deviation, again, we're trying to capture the population standard deviation between two cutoff points. Again, we have the right and the left chi-square values coming into play here. These are just the square root of the variance. So the steps for building a confidence interval for variance or standard deviation are as follows. 1, verify the population has a normal distribution. We are assuming normality here. 2, identify sample statistic n and degrees of freedom, so n minus 1. Find the point estimate for the sample variance or standard deviation, if that's what we're looking at. And then that is found through this, which is the sum of squared deviations over n minus 1 degrees of freedom. Finally, number 4, find the critical values for chi-square r and l that correspond to the level of confidence using our degrees of freedom and our level of confidence as our guides. Now the next step, 5, is finding the left and right endpoints to form the confidence interval for variance. And then if we want to go to standard deviation, we take the square root of those numbers. And so here's an example using those steps. If we randomly select and weigh 41 samples of 16-ounce bags of potato chips, and we have a sample standard deviation of 0.05, and we're assuming the weights are normally distributed, and we're going to construct a 90% confidence interval. So that gives us the values to look for, with degrees of freedom n minus 1, gives us 40. And from that, we go to our table, and we find the values we need for the right chi-square estimate, 1 minus c over 2, 1 minus 0.9 over 2 is 0.05, the area to the right, 0.95. So the critical values from that are 55.758 and 26.509. So using those chi-square values, we can calculate our left endpoint and our right endpoint for our interval. And that works out to 0.04 and 0.06.